This video tutorial I will explain web service endpoint for how to get a list of addresses for a specific user. And this is the example of one-to-many relationship. Here you can see users table. It has user-related columns. Here you can see addresses table. And it has addresses-related columns. And primary key of user table is linked in addresses table as a foreign key. And now we will see the example. Here you can see users table and it has four user records. We will see how to get addresses related to this Arun. This is the public user ID of the Arun and that we will pass it as a path parameter. And we will see how to get related addresses from this addresses table. For Arun, there are two records are there in addresses table. Here you can see user controller class, which is REST controller. Here get user addresses method, and using this method, based on the passing user ID, we can get list of addresses associated with the particular user. And this method accept user ID. And to call this method, we have to use HTTP method. And here is the path. And ID is nothing but public user ID. So based on that, list of addresses we will get. And this method produces either JSON or XML. And this method returns list of addresses REST. And here I am creating address REST list object. Then I am calling getAddresses method of addresses service object and passing the user ID. Based on the user ID, list of address DTO we will get. And in this piece of code, if address DTO list is not null, I am mapping address DTO list content to addresses REST list and returns addresses REST list to the caller. Now we will see addresses REST class. It has addresses related properties. Next we will see address DTO class. It has addresses related properties. Next, we will see address service interface. Here you can see address service interface and it has getAddresses method which accept user ID. And this method is abstract method and implementation of this method is there in address service imbl class. Here you can see address service imbl class which implements address service interface and provide implementation of getAddresses method. GetAddresses method accept user ID and here I am creating address DTO list object. Then I am calling find by user ID method of user repository object and passing user ID. And based on the user ID, it returns user entity object. If user entity object is null, then it returns empty address DTO list. And if it is not null, then here I am creating a model mapper object. Then I am calling find all by user details method of address repository and passing the user entity. And this method returns a list of address entity objects related to the particular user. And in this for loop, I am mapping address entity object to address DTO object and adding that address DTO object to address DTO list and returns address DTO list to the controller layer. Now we will see user entity class. User entity class is mapped to users table, and it has user related properties and a list of address entity. And here you can see address entity class, and it is mapped to addresses table, and it has addresses related properties. Next, you will see user repository interface. And here you can see user repository interface, and it is responsible for CRUD operation related to users table. And here you can see address repository interface, and it is responsible for CRUD operation related to addresses table. Now I will start the application in debug mode. Now I am going to send request to the login URL to get JWT token and public user ID for the user Arun. And in the body, I am passing email and password. Click on send. And status is 200 OK, so it is successful. Click on headers. Here we got a public user ID. Copy this. And what we are going to do is, for a specific user ID, we are planning to get the addresses. Paste it here. Then slash addresses. And in authorization header, you can see JWT token. Copy this. And here in header section, in authorization header, add that. Paste this. Click on send. Request reached here. Here you can see the output. We got two addresses related to the user Arun. Now I will send the request with some invalid user ID. Click on send. And here we got empty array, so it does not have any addresses. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.